Hi guys, my name is Deepak, and in this quick video, we'll talk about how to backup Windows Active Directory using Azure Backup Agent. Now, if you guys know, Windows Active Directory is part of system state. So if you backup system state, it means you can backup Windows Active Directory. Now let's look at what are the requirements to backup this information to Azure. You require the Azure subscription, you require the internet connectivity on your Active Directory server. You also need to have the Active Directory computer, which is running on Windows Server 2008, Service Pack 2, the 64-bit, or above. Now, let's look at the workflow. So, in this demo, we're going to create the Azure Backup Vault. We're going to download the backup client on the Active Directory server. We're going to register that server, and we are going to configure the backup configuration. Now, let's quickly look into the demo. So, I already have the Azure subscription. If you don't have it, you can purchase a new subscription, or you can also subscribe to a free subscription for a month as well. Now, if I go on portal.azure.com, I have got my subscription, so I have logged in, and I go and create a recovery services vault. Now, in order to save time, I've already created it, so I'm just going to show you the configuration I have done. Now, in order to make this vault usable, I have configured my backup infrastructure, and I have selected the storage which I'm going to use. So I will select whether I want geo-redundant storage or locally redundant storage. Now the difference between these two are, in the locally redundant storage, the data stays in one data center. In the geo-redundant, data is also replicated in another data center for the high availability, but it costs you extra. Now it's a choice. Now, if we just go back, now look at the configuration, what we have done. We need to come in Getting Started and click on Backup. And we need to select where the workload is running, that's on-premises, and select the system state. So after selecting that, I'm going to prepare the infrastructure. Now, it gives me the option, like I need to download this agent, and I also need to download this vault credential. Now the vault credential, it helps register the server securely to the recovery services vault. Now I have already done it and downloaded these information on my computer. Now this computer which I'm using is Active Directory server, and I have opened up my Azure console on the same box. Now I'm going to click on this installation setup, and it's going to kickstart the installation process. Now I'm going to quickly go next. I'm not using proxy, but if you want to use proxy for your Active Directory, you can select that. Now, I'll just quickly go past these options, and I'm going to install the Azure Recovery Services agent. Now, once the Recovery Services agent is installed, I'm going to register the server to the backup vault. So that would be my next step. Now, the installation is completed. I'm going to proceed to the registration. So I'm going to register the server to the backup vault. Now, in order to register, I require the vault credentials. So I'm going to select the vault credential, and it verifies that it has to connect to the backup vault, and that backup vault is at specific location. So I'm going to select next. And I also need to provide the passphrase. Now, these passphrases are required in order to encrypt the data while it's transferring to Azure. We also require these passphrases if we need to restore this backup on any other server than this box. So I'm gonna punch in the passphrase, gonna save it on the desktop as well, click OK, and click on Finish. Now the registration is completed, and you could see it gives the option to launch Microsoft Azure Recovery Services Agent, which means we can configure the backup. Now I click on Close and minimize this information, and I'm going to schedule the backup. So I'm going to click on Schedule Backup, and this would fetch the policy. If the backup is already configured, I can reconfigure it and I can make certain changes. So I'm doing it for the first time, it gives me the option and it tells that the backup system state is a new option. If you want to learn more, you can click on this option. So I'm going to click on next and going to add item. So if you have already used this backup agent in past, I'm sure you would be aware that it used to give only two options, like your drives, or one option, I would say, the drives. Now, it also gives you the option of system state. So I click on that system state, click on OK, and I'm going to click on next. Now, it's going to confirm this information, and it can finish. Now, one thing you will notice that I cannot, you know, schedule this backup. So I can't configure my own schedule, because as of now, this is configured to happen every Sunday at 9 p.m. for 60 days retention. So this is something which is non-configurable at this point of time, and hopefully this will be changed in future. So I'm gonna click on finish, and it's going to configure and schedule the backup. Now you can see the backup configuration is successful, and I can simply close it. And now my Active Directory will be backed up on every Sunday at 9 p.m. All right, thank you. This concludes the demo.